Racing to the 2022 Breeders' Cup, and this time we get an update and racing recap from the weekend. We'll go to Kentucky Downs, take a look at those races, the Irish Champion Stakes, and the Kentucky Downs Turf Cup. Lots of racing action from Kentucky Downs on Saturday. It was hot brown. Jose Ortiz in the saddle, the Mint Million, held off a couple of stretch runners down the lane, some like it hot brown. He's always just a notch below that grade one level, but he picks up the big purse here at Kentucky Downs, caps off another nice season for some like it hot brown. Now on the ladies' turf, it was Dalika, the German mare, picking up the win. Al Stahl, the trainer, and Dalika has been doing this for years now. Over $1.2 million in earnings. She's a grade one winner. She's not nominated to the Breeders' Cup. She is a German bred. We'll see if they want to supplement, but definitely another big win for Dalika. She continues to crank out the big victories. This one at Kentucky Downs, she has run well there. And who knows, maybe she'll come back next year. Dalika winning at the Kentucky Downs in the ladies' turf. Meanwhile, win and you're in Europe, we had Jadumi wire to wire. Will he go to Ascot next? Of course, he could be a contender for the Breeders' Cup Turf Mile. Maybe running one more race in Europe, and then we'll see. Nice win for Jadumi, really stretched out down the lane, kind of a cracker one, a big win for Jadumi. In the Irish Champion Stakes, it was Luxembourg defeating a strong field. He's by Camelot. Ryan Moore, the jockey, and A.P. O'Brien, the trainer. A Group 1 Stakes, Irish Champion Stakes, Luxembourg. We'll see where he goes next. Of course, Broom was in that field. Mishriff ran evenly, and some other top horses in that Irish Champion Stakes. Meanwhile, we had the Kentucky Downs Turf Cup. Red Knight gets the job done at 12-1. Mike Maker, the trainer. Red Knight holding off Gufo, who had won a grade one race in his last race at Saratoga. Quick turnaround for Gufo, but a nice win for Red Knight. He's always kind of been running on the fringes of those grade twos and grade threes. Picks up a nice purse in the Kentucky Turf Cup. Arklow disappointed. He was bet down, kind of faded on the turn. Breeders' Cup prep season starting to hit full swing now the next 3 weeks. We've got the Woodward Stakes, the Lucas Classic, the Pennsylvania Derby, the Belle Dame, and the Spinster for the Distaff division, along with the Woodbine Mile. And for the two-year-old division, Future Stars Friday, we've got the Frisette Stakes and the Champagne Stakes. Those are both at a mile. Those will be at the Big A because the Belmont Fall Meet is being run at Aqueduct this year. And then the Alcibiades and the Keeneland Futurity, those will be opening weekend at Keeneland just a few weeks away as they start off the September-October meet. Now the Pennsylvania Derby going to be pretty deep field, still confirming some more starters, but it looks like you're going to have White Abario. They are confirmed for that race. Best Actor, a couple of nice wins back-to-back. Taba, he's been working out west for trainer Bob Baffert. Of course, he lost the Haskell the last time. Meanwhile, Simplification continues to work out. St. Tappet, 2-for-2 for trainer Todd Pletcher. Tawny Port with a string of workouts for Brad Cox. And We the People, again, three-year-olds straight up, $1 million purse. Kind of the last chance for three-year-olds to get a big purse before they have to face older horses. And right now, that's looking like a good deep field. Still a possibility of maybe even getting a horse like Zandon or even a Cyberknife in there if they choose to go that route. Now, the Cotillion, Secret Oath, the Kentucky Oaks winner for DeWayne Lucas. She is training at Saratoga, continues to point for that. Adari Manor for Bob Baffert. Moira, the winner up in Canada, Woodbine the last time out, beat the boys. Goddess of Fire for Todd Pletcher, who lost to Nest. Green Up, who's won four straight, won the prep at Parks for this race. And then Gerrymander may cut back from the mile and a quarter. Of course, a big win in the Mother Goose earlier this year for trainer Chad Brown. That's a deep Cotillion field. Also, a grade one stakes before the fillies have to face the older horses. And Cotillion is usually drawing some pretty good runners. Looks like it could be a nice deep field this year. Of course, the Belle Dame Stakes coming up at Belmont. And then you've also got the Spinster Stakes. Malathot possibly targeting the Spinster Stakes along with Search Results. They could have a rematch. Then in the Belle Dame Stakes, which is a grade two this year, you could have the possibility of Ness going in that race, although I think more than likely she could train up to the Breeders' Cup Distaff. We did have an update on the Distaff division earlier this week. Now the Lucas Classic, that one's pointing out as a nice full field. You could have Rich Strike Of course, Kentucky Derby winner at 80-1, ran an even fourth in the Travers Stakes. Happy Saver, he worked out on Friday for Todd Pletcher. He is either going to run in the Lucas Classic or the Woodward. Hot Rod Charlie worked out 6 furlongs for Doug O'Neill. Looks like he's going to go to the Lucas Classic. Fulsome, a winner the last time out in the mountains of West Virginia. Title ready for Dallas Stewart. He'll be a long shot in that race. And then King Fury, a workout over the weekend for Ken McPeak. Lucas Classic, a grade two this year. Big purse, and you're already in Kentucky. That'll be probably pick up one or two classic starters maybe in that Lucas Classic. Now the Woodward Stakes, that is starting to shape up. Probably a small field. Life is Good is going to point for that. Of course, Todd Pletcher going to have a decision on Happy Saver and Life is Good. Life is Good, the Whitney winner the last time out. He beat Olympiad, who came back to win the Jockey Club Gold Cup last week. And then Art Collector, he won the Charlestown Classic and the Woodward last year. He's going to try to maybe double it up. Of course, Art Collector ran in the Breeders' Cup Classic last year for trainer Bill Mott. Look, see if he continues that same pattern this year. It wasn't much of a factor in the running of that race, but that time Nick's Go went pretty much wire to wire with Essential Quality and Hot Rod Charlie in that field last year for the Breeders' Cup Classic. Now the Turf Sprint, lots of horses still considering this one. Usually that field oversubscribes. You've got Golden Pale. They may not run on the dirt at Keeneland now. There was some word about that. Casa Creed, I think most likely he shows up in that Turf Sprint coming out of the big win the last time out at Saratoga. A Case of You, Acklam Express, and Highfield Princess. Definitely probably going to get 7 or 8 runners considering from Europe to come over for that big purse in the Turf Sprint on Breeders' Cup. So that could definitely be a full division of the Turf Sprint. Of course, the Turf Sprint. Then you've got the Juvenile Turf and the Juvenile Fillies. A lot of the European runners point for that race. They enter that race. Those are usually the oversubscribed fields. The Turf Mile this year looks like that one could be an 8 or 9 horse field. You've got the possibility of Regal Glory going next at Keeneland, then see if she runs in the Breeders' Cup. So the turf races, I think they're going to continue to have full fields. Breeders' Cup at Keeneland this year, where it's going to get interesting is the Classic and the Dirt Mile. If they don't want to face Flightline, Flightline going to train up to the Breeders' Cup Classic. And one quick note about the Travers. We did have 3 horses come out of that race, Cyberknife, Epicenter, and Zandon. They all worked out over the track on Saturday. All 3 are listed as pointing potentially for the Breeders' Cup Classic. Of course, those are 3-year-olds going to maybe take on the older horses. Subscribe to the Horse Player. We're back on Monday with our Horse Player. We're going to lead you up to the Breeders' Cup, of course, Season 2. You can hit the description below and click that link. That's what you'll see. Sign up for the Horse Player. And don't forget, people have opinions. Horses have the facts. What did you think about the Kentucky Downs racing on Saturday? Leave a comment as we get you ready for the Breeders' Cup 2022.